Trump-hating Kathy Griffin posts unhinged video as she gets the worst news of her career. Kathy Griffin continues to beg for sympathy after posting a disgusting photo depicting the beheading of President Donald Trump, which rocked the nation 6 months ago. The unhinged Trump hater has struck yet again, dropping another bombshell. In a recent video posted to her account, Griffin not only openly admits that she's lost her mind, she reveals the worst news of her career that just hit her hard, and it's something you don't want to miss. 6 months ago, Kathy Griffin grabbed the attention of millions of Americans when she posted a picture meant to represent the beheading of President Trump as the washed-up celebrity clutched his bloody, severed head in her hands. Naturally, many Americans were outraged, and her stunt even earned her a visit from the Secret Service. Following the massive backlash, Griffin has tried time and time again to restore any career she might have left. After making a YouTube channel and posting videos hoping for some attention, she has accomplished nothing but embarrassing herself even further. You would think she might want to stay clear of the spotlight, but for someone with little common sense, she makes it clear she is far too desperate and begging isn't beneath her, although accountability for her own actions is definitely a foreign concept. In her latest tirade in a video posted to Griffin's YouTube channel, which she titled Kathy Griffin's State of the Union, she displays just how completely unhinged she has become, openly admitting that she has lost her mind, something everyone else knew long ago. While addressing her cringeworthy behavior, she had the audacity to complain about the continued fallout from her Trump beheading stunt. Griffin whined about the mounting repercussions, claiming it has not only consisted of her name being on Interpol, but she is also allegedly on a Hollywood blacklist and her legal bills are allegedly through the roof. It seems beyond her comprehension that perhaps she's not getting work because she's actually a talentless hack who disgusts the majority of Americans. I just want you guys to know that I am fully in the middle of a blacklist, like I'm in the middle of a Hollywood blacklist. It is real. I'm not booked on any talk shows, Griffin whined, as reported to the Gateway Pundit. When I get home, I do not have one single day of paid work in front of me, Griffin continued. Then, the delusional diva put her entitlement mentality on full display. While graveling about how she wants to get back to work, she mentions that some have suggested she do the club scene again. However, Griffin quickly brushed off the suggestion, believing she is too good for that type of work. Apparently, she believes she's worked too hard in her life and is above that type of work. Someone should tell her that desperate times call for desperate measures and her unwillingness to do what it takes to put food on the table only further alienates her from any possible fan base since she obviously can't connect with the average American. Does she forget the part where she was the one who threw any career she had down the toilet, forcing herself to start over completely? Hell, she should be grateful to do the club scene if she can get a gig because, at this point, most of us wouldn't even want her flipping our burgers. Usually, when you hit rock bottom, you don't get to be picky, hence the old saying, beggars can't be choosers, and Griffin is definitely a beggar right about now, as evidenced by her YouTube video, where begging is all she does. It's cringeworthy, but delightful to see her floundering at the same time. Along with the incessant whining, blaming, and dodging of all accountability for the position she's in, Griffin claims that she has to turn down fundraising requests because she is buried in legal bills following the bloody Trump head photo shoot, but I find it hard to believe anyone would book her even for a charity event. Who would want to bring that kind of bad publicity to their cause? Showing just how delusional she has become, a paranoid Griffin also rambled on about how Harvey Weinstein hired a company to follow Rose McGowan around after she came forward about Hollywood sexual assault. Then, Griffin implied she may be next before reiterating that she has no work when she returns home from her tour. Of course, she also claims it's all because she's being targeted because she's a woman. She wrapped up her pity party by begging for a gig on a television show. How about no, Kathy? Can you blame anyone for not wanting to work with her? I mean, with this kind of crazy, you'd almost worry it could be contagious. Kathy Griffin doesn't need another gig, she needs to be taught a lesson. When you make a poor decision, you reap the consequences, something she obviously hasn't learned, even though the majority of Americans have all but beat it into her. This is why you don't have a job, Kathy. You're not a victim, you're a bully who's getting their comeuppance. Now, that's the best entertainment you've provided in years.